Assalamu alaikum. This is our second video on divisibility rules. In this video, we will study about 4 and 5. How we will know that a big number is divisible by 4 or 5. So first, we will study 4. Now, we know the table of 4 till 100. It is easy. But if it is above 100 or greater than thousands and 10,000, so it is difficult for us. Therefore, we will see the last two digits, or we will see the unit and tens of that number. For example, 472. So we don't know table still here. We will see the unit and tens of this number. If they are divisible by 4, we will say that this number is also divisible by 4. For example, 72 is divisible by 4. Yes. Or directly we can say that 4 18s are 72. Now we will check that this is divisible by 4 or not. 4 ones are 4, 4 ones are 4, 3 will come here, 4 8s are 32. So yes, it is divisible. Another example, 3780. We will see the unit and tens of this number. If they are divisible by 4, we will say the whole number is divisible by 4. So 80 is divisible by 4 or not? Yes, it is divisible. So this number is also divisible. Why not to check? You can use this method of division or this method, no problem. For 9s are 36. 1 will come here. For 4s are 16, so 2 will come here, 4, 5 are 20. Therefore, we came to know that if the unit and tens of a number is divisible by 4, the whole number is divisible by 4. Got it? Now, another example will give you 3411. This unit and tens, they aren't divisible by 4. You know that. 4 2s are 8, and then decimal will come, or the remainder will come. Therefore, this is not divisible by 4. Let's check this. So, for 8s are 32. If we subtract, we'll get 2 here. 1 will come down. 4 5s are 20. 1 will come down, another 1 will come down. 4 2s are 10. Sorry, 4 2s are 8. So 3 will be remainder. Therefore, we can solve this and put here decimal, and we can further proceed, but no need. We need the answer, the quotient, as a whole number without a decimal or without a remainder. Therefore, you'll write here no. Any other numbers, small numbers, suppose in 128. Clear? We will see the unit and tens of this number. Yes, 7 for the 28. We will say yes, this number is divisible. Another number, 129. We will check these two numbers. 29 is divisible by 4? No. So the whole number is not divisible by 4. Got it? Okay. Now I'll explain rule for 5. Okay. If the unit of a number is 0 or 5, suppose like 0. So we will say yes, this number is divisible by 5. 5 tens are. Now, if the unit is 5. See, this is 5. So we will say this number is also divisible by 5. Okay, let's take little bit big examples. 550. Again, there is 0. So yes. 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5, 0 will go up. Clear? Another example, 5, 6, 5, 5 and 5. Now, again, we will divide by 5. 5 on the 5, 1 will come here. 5 3 is 15. 5 on the 5, 5 on the 5. So we saw that this number is also divisible by 5. Now I told you in the beginning that if a number carries 0 at the unit place, but I did not tell you if there are multiple zeros. So again, that number will be divisible by 5. For example, this number carries multiple zeros. So yes, this number is also divisible by 5. 5 and the 5, all zeros will go up. Another example, suppose 7 0 0, or let me make it 5. Clear? So 5 on the 5, 2 will come here, 5 4s are 20, the 0 will go up, and 5 on the 5. Clear? Let's check this, it is correct or not. Yes. So we will write here, yes, this number is also divisible by 5, because there is 5 in the unit. 1 5 or more 5, 1 0 or more zeros, a number carries at the right side or at the end. So that number will be divisible by 5. Another example, 7700. Yes, this is divisible because there are 2 zeros. I told you, if there is 1 zero or multiple zeros, that number will be divisible by 5. 5 on the 5, 5 5s are 25, 5 4s are 20, 0 will go up. I hope you understood. If there is any question, ask me in the comment box, or you can also contact me by email on Classera. Thank you very much.